Hey guys, this is David Kwan. I should have made this video on New Year's Day, or at the very least January 2nd, because I want to wish you guys Happy New Year. I was too lazy, not motivated enough to make a video when I should have, but here I am. I hope your 2013 started out awesomely, and if it has, that it continues to be awesome. If it started out rough, like mine did, well then I hope it gets better, and I hope 2013 becomes one of those years you look back on and be like, yeah, that was quite an awesome year for me. Or at least if it doesn't turn out to be that way, and it just turns out to be like 2013 has a lot of lessons and a lot of great experiences for you. That's my wish for you. For right now, me personally, 2013 started out with what I like to call a kick in the balls or a kick in the nuts. I call that the events when things happen in life that's just like, God damn it, like, why did that have to happen, kind of thing. So the kick in the nuts happened at January 2nd. My New Year's Day was kind of uneventful. As usual, I spent most of my New Year's with my parents. There's only one time in my life where I didn't spend the New Year's in the church. That was 2011, I believe, and 2011 into 2012, I spent New Year's in a homeless shelter working. All the other times I spent it at the church, because my dad as a pastor likes to have a service right on December 31st, and like at 10 p.m. or 11 p.m., and the service goes into New Year's, so that's his way of devoting like the very first hour and minute of your life of a new year to God. So it's always been like a family tradition to, you know, spend New Year's at church. We don't count down and we don't watch the whole Rockefeller Center countdown, whatever. I don't know. That's just how it is being a pastor's son, I suppose, or pastor's kid. But yeah, nothing too eventful. I just got to chill out at my home. The big thing happened at January 2nd. My boss at my work called me. It started out with, you know, the regular small talk, like, hey, it's good to talk with you. Happy New Year's, blah, blah, blah. The kick in the balls was that the door office, which is door canvassing office, which was I was working, was closing down. Yeah, apparently, while I was on vacation, the higher-ups, the fundraising company, decided that the door office in New York City, Manhattan, wasn't either doing well enough, or maybe the whole structure wasn't sustainable enough for fundraising purposes, that this is decided to close it down. And it would be closed on Friday, January 6th or 5th, I believe, the day after I would come back from New York. So I actually did get to work on the very last day that the office was open. But yeah, that was quite a blow, just because I had come to really feel confident with the job. I gotten promoted recently, so I felt a lot of pride just doing the work that I do with that job and feeling confident and comfortable with it, and now that was gone. So it didn't leave me jobless, but it did make me feel like I was gonna lose my job pretty damn soon. 'Cause once door office closed, what's left in New York City is the street office for the company. It's still pretty much the same concept. We still talk about an important issue like gay rights and the environment, and we still, you know, make people become aware of those issues, and we still try to get them involved so they would, you know, donate and contribute as much as they can to our cause. Still the same basic concept of fundraising and raising public awareness, stuff like that. Still the same mission, same goal. It's just that the method is different. Door canvassing, what we do is we go to different neighborhoods and we knock on people's doors and we talk to them that way. Street canvassing is, as the name implies, we're out on the streets in front of markets or in front of stores and just, you know, waving to people on staying on one place in the street, waving to people and encouraging them to stop and talk to us and raising public issues awareness that way. I've always felt more comfortable just knocking on people's doors, and you know, I could probably do another video about the differences that I felt with door-to-door canvassing and street canvassing, but that's probably another video. But yeah, that's, I expected my transition from becoming a door canvasser field manager to being a street canvasser. And my anticipation, my expectation turned out to be correct, because it was a tough and awkward transition for me. It was really, really tough. And, you know, beginning the year like that, like not certain whether I would be able to keep this job, perform well to keep this job, or become jobless again, you know, it's quite a way to start the year. Definitely, that's definitely been a life tradition for me. The only time that wasn't like that was 2012, where I started on solid footing, like with a stable job and everything. 2011, that wasn't the case. 2010, I was in college still, but that certainly wasn't the case where I felt like comfortable with, like, I felt like I knew where my life was heading. 2013, definitely not the case. I have no idea where my life is heading. I have some ideas here and there, but definitely a lot of uncertainties. A lot of plan A's, B's, C's, D's, and E's and whatnot. Like, my life could go this way, my life could go that way. Just no idea. But up to this point, it's now January 23rd. I actually do feel pretty comfortable and confident with where I'm at. The only question in my mind is whether I can keep at it. So that's going to be the challenge for me, to keep doing the best I can to maintain this. Because 2013, so this year, turned out to be the year actually, it was time for me to apply to grad school. It finally became the time, and I applied 2 weeks ago. So that was quite something. It's unbelievable. 3 years after I graduated college, I feel like I'm behind everyone else. If life was a race among my colleagues, I'd be in last place. Because I think, you know, just looking at Facebook, it's just like all my colleagues have graduate degrees, have jobs that I envy. And so maybe if I was competing with them, I would definitely be in last place, because I just have a bachelor's and a whole bunch of experiences and this and that and whatever. But, you know, good thing I don't see life as a race. Otherwise, you know, I'd be quite upset. But yeah, I think it's finally time. My mom started work again, so she could provide for me. Although I feel guilty about that, but she could. Definitely. And all our family's income are now super low. My income is like near poverty level. My dad definitely is. My mom's is fairly low. The problem with my first year in college, my problem with my undergraduate, was that my mom made a six-figure salary. She made so much money that she wasn't eligible for any financial aid. We weren't, you know, eligible for any financial aid whatsoever. That's why all my loans were private, from Citibank. And now, of course, some are shared by Discover, because Discover bought some of the loans of Citibank, but that's a whole other topic. See, that was a big issue. And with grad school, I don't think that's really going to be an issue. I think I would get some pretty good financial aid. And if not, it's only one more year as a master's program in social work. If you already have a BSW, you could do this program called Advanced Standing, where it only takes 1 year to complete. So even if federal grants are kind of out of the question, or I could still do it, it's still an affordable option for me. So that's good. I can finally afford it. The 3 years before this one, I could not. So it's finally come to that point. And I've also finally feel comfortable enough and confident enough to apply to it. I found good references, finally. You know, people who have... And I finally had good 3 years experience doing whatever the things I was doing. A lot of the... It's not much, but I think it still helps. I worked as a tutor tutoring students in low-income families. I worked at a homeless shelter serving 200 homeless clients diagnosed with mental illnesses and chemical addictions. I've now become involved in political canvassing. And I guess those are the three things that I've done in the 3 years. You know, not much, but definitely helpful, I think, to apply to grad school. I think these are the best conditions I have to apply to grad school. So if I don't get accepted, I don't know, I think applying to grad school is kind of over if I don't get accepted, because I could not have asked for better conditions, and I would not really know why I failed. The only reason they would not accept me is because my GPA from my undergrad is not that high. It's like 2.98 or something like that. So if that's the case, then I'm kind of screwed. I would have to think about other ways to go on with my life. And I guess I have some plan A's, plan B's, and plan C's in mind. But they're not really all that desirable to my ideal plan of keeping this job or another job, something stable, just keeping a job until I get into grad school and having a part-time job with grad school. And then, you know, going on to do whatever I want to do with a master's in social work, become a social worker. That would be ideal. If I don't get accepted, then plan B would, you know, I'm applying to be a citizen in February, a U.S. citizen. So that would allow me to apply to be to join Peace Corps, which would be great because I always plan to join Peace Corps sometime in my life. It is definitely something I've always wanted to do in my life. But if I don't get accepted, I would probably start that a lot sooner than I want to. So that would be plan B. Plan C, I don't know, apply for Teach for America. Plan D, I don't know, if all else fails, join the military? Shoot, I don't know. The last resort would be something my dad wants me to do, which is join this ministry college to become like an evangelist minister. Not too thrilled about that idea, but that's definitely one of the things that I could do. I don't know. Life is definitely uncertain. It's a new year. There's going to be a lot of new journeys, a lot of new experiences. But that's some of just me thinking about my life. You know, so far, I kind of like where I'm at. It's so weird because right before I'm graduating college, like the thing I'm thinking about is like, okay, now I got to make a difference. Here's like, I have all these ambitions, all these new things I want to start. And so like, I'm always been like fighting to like, you know, just get to higher and higher ground, get something new and keep improving. But 3 years down the road, it's not even that much time. It feels like so much has gone by since I graduated college, but 3 years down the road, it's just kind of like just fighting to keep what I have. You know, it's not fighting to have something new. It's not struggling to just improve and for better ambitions. It's really just trying my best to keep this, to you know, to maintain just stability. And it's weird. I don't know. Right now, I just think I'm buying myself time. Time to have that ambition again, you know. After grad school, if I do get into grad school, I'm pretty confident that I will because I'm going back to my alma mater, NYU. But after grad school, who knows what will happen then. Graduate degree doesn't necessarily mean I get what I want to do. It gives me a better opportunity, especially in the social work field. I would have to get licensed. I would, you know, in graduate school, I'd probably be connected with an internship, and that would go a long way towards providing a better future for me in terms of, yeah, but I don't know, new year, new journey. I just hope that I keep doing as best as I could, and I hope that I could at least maintain what I have, and then buy enough time to start worrying about bigger ambitions and bigger goals.